In this video, you're gonna learn 10 essential concepts of Google Tag Manager you need to master if you want to become an efficient GTM implementer. All and more coming up right after this. Hi there, and welcome to another video of measureschool.com, where we teach you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian, and in this video, we're gonna talk about 10 essential things you need to master in Google Tag Manager. Now, I have trained many students over the past few years in GTM and have found these to be the essential concepts of the tool that you need to really understand in order to be efficient in implementing tags with GTM. But I also might get this totally wrong, so I'm looking forward to your feedback in the comments below about this video. Now, we got lots to cover, so let's dive in. We'll start out by talking about the preparation part. What do you need to get your work done in GTM fast? Number one, planning. Before starting to implement anything with Google Tag Manager, you need to have an overview of what actually needs to be done or implemented. So especially for bigger implementations, I would recommend to plan out your implementation in advance and start inputting tags, triggers, variables step by step and not all at once. Check out our video on the tag deployment process if you want to find out more. Number two, setup. Google Tag Manager is not usable if not correctly installed and configured. You need to be able to make sure it works flawlessly on all pages and be able to debug any installation or setup problems. Also, the account setup requires special attention to organize future needs with workspaces, environments, and user management features. Number three, workflow. Having a set workflow lets you implement your tags fast, more efficiently, and most importantly, consistently. There are different best practices that have evolved over the past few years, and GTM helps you to implement those with the features of version control, for example, or preview and debugging, or having a naming convention for your tags, triggers, and variables. So be sure to learn about these workflow habits in advance. All right. In the last three points, we covered some preparations. Now let's dive into the concepts you need to understand to master GTM. Number four, GTM components. Google Tag Manager consists of tag, triggers, variables, and the data layer. Did you know that they all interconnect and can't exist separately? Having a solid understanding of these components and their connection to each other is important. Especially if you run into trouble, you need to know how to go backtrack and check these components and see if they work correctly or as expected. So better learn about these GTM components if you are not confident in their function yet. Which leads us to number five, the GTM data layer. Now, the data layer is a pretty inaccessible piece of technical jargon if you're just getting started with GTM. But believe me, it can be super powerful once you get to know how it actually works in conjunction with your components and how you can utilize the data layer for your tracking. Everything really is built on a data layer in GTM. And if you want to master GTM, you better understand how to pull in information, push information into the data layer, and how it can interact with your tags, triggers, and variables. Number six, GTM events. Once you understood the data layer, it's time to dive into another important dimension of GTM. This is the concept of time. Now, time is represented in the data layer events that you can use to trigger your tags upon. They act kind of like checkpoints that you can control your variables, fire your tags, and control sequence within your tag deployment. And no, they absolutely don't have anything in common with Google Analytics event. So if you don't know what they are, check out our latest video on events in Google Tag Manager and Google Analytics. Number seven, know your HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Now, Google Tag Manager is always seen as this non-technical solution to a pretty much technical problem. But really, it is a fancy JavaScript injector. Meaning, if you want to get efficient in using it, it is necessary to know your HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Basically, the foundation of how a website is built. The more, the better. Check out Codecademy, we'll link that up below in the description, to get you started learning these concepts of modern web development. All right, enough with all the specifics on Google Tag Manager. Let's talk about some principles that you will learn with experience, really. Number 8, the advantages and shortcomings of GTM. Once you understand the technical details of Google Tag Manager a bit closer, you will understand that JavaScript can't do everything, and therefore GTM also has some limitations. As long as you stay in the browser, GTM can help you track all kinds of interactions. But once you leave the browser, GTM can't be used as easily. So be aware of the shortcomings and adjust your measurement plan accordingly. And number 9, debugging. Every seasoned GTM implementer has run into trouble at some point. Knowing how you can debug your installation and find the root cause can only be learned by knowing the tools of the trade. Now, one of these tools would obviously be the preview and debug console, the JavaScript console within the developer tools, or something more complicated like a tool like Fiddler that will reveal what went wrong in the JavaScript. But sometimes you might get stuck, so you need to master our last principle, number 10, where to get help. The last point is a natural one in any learning experience. To reach any kind of mastery, you will need to know what to do when you get stuck. So being able to know where to first look for help needs to be second nature to you. In our GTM guide, we have listed the best resources to learn Google Tag Manager, such as blogs, experts to follow, books, and more. You can download it for free on our website. We'll have a link down below. So there you have it, 10 concepts to master within GTM. Now I want to hear from you. Which of these points are you struggling with the most? Is there anything I forgot? Let me know in the comments below and I'll make sure to help you out and maybe even do another video on it. And as always, if you liked this video, please share it to your friends or a colleague. Subscribe to this channel as well, because we will produce more videos every Wednesday. My name is Julian. Till next time.